A section of the One Kenya Alliance now says it will consider reviving the collapsed BBI constitutional review process through the parliamentary initiative.
Well, Tiaty Member of Parliament William Kamket of KANU Party says that they are exploring the parliamentary option to pass some of the proposals contained in the BBI report.
But as ANC Party Leader Musalia Mudavadi blamed the fall of the BBI on, or rather the bill, on failure by the proponents to consider views from other quarters, thereby making the initiative an elite political affair. Let's get more from our very own Chemtai Gowi.
Speaking in Tiaty constituency, Kamket said they were exploring other options of initiating the proposed changes to the constitution, including the option of parliament.
Hiyo idea ya kubadilisha katiba haijaisha. Tutafanya ile tutaweza katika bunge. The ideas remain with us. Us as the proponents of reform, we shall forever cherish and push those ideas until those ideas are achieved. That is our objective as the reform group.
With the ensuing blame game over what went wrong, Kamket pointed an accusing finger at unnamed individuals in government whom he said had orchestrated the fall of one of President Kenyatta's pet projects.
All the moles in government must be swept aside and it must be done immediately. We cannot afford to go to war with people shooting us from the back.
Elsewhere, ANC party leader Musalia Mudavadi is blaming BBI proponents for what he termed failure to make the process all-inclusive.
In Bomas 1, I said that if we are going to engage in a conversation of this nature, unless we are pulling everybody together, we are going to have difficulty, and this document might turn out to be an elite document. A political elite document and not a document that affects the mwananchi. Now, when you listen to the rulings, some of the words that are used in Bomas 3 years ago were some of the words that the judges were pronouncing in their judgment.
With BBI virtually off the table, political energy is likely to shift to firming up of political formations ahead of the 2022 elections.
Let us not make the mistake of thinking, especially for politicians, let us not think we are a one-man choir. We must dialogue as we move forward so that we can have free and fair elections in 2022.
We need to unite and restore, begin a national conversation that restores order in the country.
Niko na imani kwamba ile mrengo yangu tutaform serikali ijayo.
On the 9th of August 2022, the name of His Excellency Dr. Stephen Kalonzo Musyoka will be in the presidential ballot as a presidential candidate.
Chemutai Goin, Citizen TV.